Good afternoon, and welcome back to Asgard, and welcome back to Sky Factory 3. First off, I do apologize, there was not a video on Saturday. I tried and tried to get, you know, ahead on the videos, and it just didn't work out. And of course, I was out for the weekend and everything. And so then I've been, you know, trying to get caught back up, more or less, since then. But anyways, I've been working on the front of the ship as well as some on the sides here. I still got to put in windows and build the turbine. And then also kind of smoothing out the top, working on this. Also a bit of testing and a bit of automation as well. I wanted all the solar panels, you know, automated so that we could order those. And so I've got it all the way up to the Draconic solar panel. You'll notice it bugs out. It's something with refined storage, I think. It acts up like this. But up until this point, you know, it's all pretty well straightforward. The Wyvern core, nothing crazy. Draconic energy core, nothing all that crazy. However, of course, the chaotic solar panel, the one that we're really gunning for, is a little bit more crazy. But it makes sense. I mean, this thing generates 524,000 RF per tick. I did go ahead and craft up some awakened cores. Now, long term, I want to get this automated so that we can just order chaotic solar panels, we can order awakened cores, we can order draconic ingots and all that good stuff. You know, I want that stuff, or awakened draconium. That's what I was trying to think of. I want it automated so that we can just order that stuff. However, of course, the fusion crafter, you know, has a bunch of different slots. But anyways, the issue that arises with this is that you have, you know, all these different slots, and you have duplicates of items, and those items can be stacked, and but they don't need to stack, and it's a little bit of a headache. Now, we could always set it up so that it just has, like, a stack in each of them on hand, and have different ones for, you know, automatically crafting. You can also do some stuff with things like translocators. I believe those are in the pack. Yeah, there's translocators. I mean, there's a few different things that you can do to automate it. Also things like Steve's Factory Manager and RF Tools Control, stuff like that can automate the Fusion Crafter. But there's a very, very easy way to automate it if you're willing to put in a little bit of effort to get it. And that is actually through Blood Magic's item conduit transfer. And so long term, that's what we're going to be going for. Today, we're going to briefly start Blood Magic after we do a little bit of crafting. Let me actually throw some of this stuff in here just to kind of free up our inventory a tad. But anyways, long term, that's what we're going to be going for. So we're going to be going for Blood Magic. And what better reason to start Blood Magic than the item conduits? Because those are, hands down, probably the smartest, most intelligent, and best well-rounded item conduits in the game at the moment. They're absolutely wonderful. But first up, I do want to go ahead and just get a few of those solar panels because, you know, that's what we were planning on doing. So I made a half stack here. I think, all in all, we're going to need 5 crafts. That's 20 of these. And then we're also going to need, I believe, 20 draconic solar panels. So let me go ahead and order those. We'll want 20 of them. Oh my gosh. This is the awesome lag that you get when you order anything that takes much of anything with draconic evolution. Or with refined storage. Okay, we are going to need dragon's breath. And quite a bit of it, might I add. So let me, what stage is it that needs, okay, it's those. Probably should have been getting dragon's breath before. I totally forgot that it was actually needed for the solar panels. But we can make ourselves some of these end crystals. Realistically, they're not they're not expensive at all for us at this point. And we'll go ahead and just spawn ourselves an Ender Dragon here. Okay, I didn't actually bring any arrows with me, but that's okay. We can do Arrow of Draconic Fire. Might as well, right? Actually, we could just open melee these. It's not really an issue, but that's okay. We have an, Wow. Those arrows of Draconic Fire actually take a lot of energy. Wow, look at that damage. Get you some, Ender Dragon. Okay. Now, I need him to start casting his Dragon Fire on us. In fact, if he would be so kindly. Okay, so we have a stack in 17 right now. And we'll go ahead and bring him down. I feel like that's probably plenty for the time being. Oh wow, and our dragon egg just like fell on the ground. That's awesome. Alright, so we've got all of our stuff now, and so let's head on back. That should be just enough to get our 20 solar panels, because it takes like 2 per craft, and it's like a lower tier. I can't recall which one it is, but and there we go. So we'll get those crafting. Those will take a minute. I'm assuming that's crafting all the mirrors at the moment. Yeah. It's crafting through all the different mirrors and all that jazz. And it looks like it just started using nether stars. So, and we'll go ahead and start getting some of this stuff sorted. We'll put our awakened cores onto this. And then our chaos shards, which I think I'm just going to use all these for solar panels. I mean, there's the chaotic cores that we could craft to make things like chaotic tier upgrades. And then the chaotic fusion crafting injectors. But it's not anything that we really need at this particular moment, I don't feel like. So I'm just going to dump them all into solar panels. So we're going to have ourselves a bunch of solar panels, or, you know, a bunch of power production going on. So anyways, let's give that a second to get crafted up. And then while we're waiting on that, we're going to go ahead and start jumping into, whoa, this lag is real. Oh my gosh. I will say that we're slowly killing the server with this series, I think. Was that total? Soul Panther 6? Yeah, it needs 1,707 photovoltaic cells. It's so expensive. So expensive. But we're gonna get 15 of those solar panels, though. That's the crazy thing, because each of those crafts is 3 per craft. But anyways, while we're waiting on that, because it is going to take a little bit, we're going to start getting into blood magic. Which it looks like we actually have some demonic wheel from somewhere. Which I don't know where that's from. I don't believe we have anything in our blood magic area. Oh my gosh, this rubber banding is legit. I'll tell you what. Anyways, we're going to go ahead and put our travel anchor down here. Let's go ahead and call it blood magic. This is going to be our blood magic area, which we still have to kind of decorate it and stuff like that. But basically, this is beneath the farms, or beneath the area beneath the farms. So it's kind of out of sight there. So anyways, the first thing that we're going to need is our blood altar, which is fairly cheap. We do need a demonic wheel, which, like I said, we've got one of those. Or we've got some of those from somewhere. I don't really know where those came from, if I'm being totally honest. But that's okay. And why they're all one wheel quality, I have no clue, actually. Unless they came from an old loot bag or something like that. That's my only guess. Because normally what you would do is you would get yourself some of these snares. So we'll grab ourselves like a couple stacks of these. Just so I can at least show you guys if you're curious. Okay, I actually just got kicked from the server. So, oh, this lag is real. Alright, I'm going to give this just a bit to hopefully craft through that, and then maybe I'll be able to log back on the server, because it's not allowing me right now. So, Anyways, I'll be back in a few. All right, welcome back. The server's finally back up, and I've discovered that apparently it's just not going to craft it. Because I can go in and I can request, say, a solar panel, just one. There's one of these, and it'll basically just get stuck. And I mean, all this stuff that it's trying to craft is all just, you know, it's just sent to crafters. It's nothing, you know, there's no processing, there's no really room for error because I just shift-clicked every, you know, all these recipes in here. It knows how to make all this stuff. It's just a major, it's just a big issue with refined storage. It's not the first time I've ran into situations like that, and I'm sure it won't be the last. That's why I'm not a huge fan of refined storage, as you guys probably are aware, because of the fact that it just doesn't work as well as it could. So anyways, we're just gonna have to manually craft this stuff up. Oh man, this is gonna be a little bit annoying. I don't know if maybe that's what's causing it, is the bottles having to do with maybe the dragon's breath. I can do something like that. I don't know. I mean, it's just, it doesn't actually work. But anyways, there's our first bit of draconic solar panels. What we'll do is we'll just start with 8, and then I'll make the rest of these off camera, because that's still going to produce like 6 solar panels, which regardless is going to be massive, massive power gen. Even, I mean, realistically, only one craft of this would be massive. So 2 crafts, that's fine. We'll go with that for now, during the episode, and then I'll continue expanding it, you know, moving forward. Oh, our pedestal tier is too low. I did not realize that this takes chaotic to do that. My bad. So we're going to need chaotic pedestals to even attempt this. So there goes our chaos shards for the time being. But that's okay. We're not going to let it deter us. We're still going to push forward. So let's get ourselves some awakened draconium. Okay, so that's running. It's going to make 5 of those chaos cores. I totally forgot that that actually requires. That's one of the few things that actually requires chaotic tier. So totally forgot about that, needless to say. But let me actually fly out. Now that we're at the 10,000, negative 10,000, probably the easiest way to do this is just going to be to fly in a specific direction. I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to fly like straight north, and we'll come across another chaos dragon if we do that. And one thing that I will do is we can actually do our flight speed up to 600. But it shouldn't take us too long to reach the next chaos dragon. And we'll do a quick battle with that and get ourselves some more chaos shards, because you get 5 chaos shards per dragon. And we're going to need a minimum of 8 pedestals. So that'll leave us 2 chaos shards for crafting. That'll be perfect for our draconic solar panel count. And we'll be okay. We will be fine. So that's what we're going to do. We'll plan on that. We'll make 2 crafts, and then I'll probably end up killing some more, maybe some more chaos dragons after this episode, and we'll be able to get more solar panels, I guess, if we want more power. All right, so let's do this. Here we go. Because one shot takes these out, so. Oh, man. Okay, somehow we've gotten 2 chaos dragons. Like, I haven't died as of yet. You can see that my capacitor is pretty well drained out right now, but oh my god, it's the other one. I'm trying to focus down one of these at the moment. Oh man. The fact that we've somehow managed to get two of these is incredible. It'll be even more incredible if we manage to kill them all. God! Trying to get that one finished off here. There's one down. Okay. Alright, I just saw a dragon heart pop into our inventory. I've got this one on the run. It's crazy because the last time we killed the Chaos Dragon, it was just one of them, and I actually died. Like, I think, twice if you count the Superior Armor stuff, or three times, something like that, but so far we haven't died on the double battle yet. There we go. And the second one is down. Thank goodness. So let's get our Chaos Shards. Tell you what, I'm just gonna warp back after we get our Chaos Shards. I'm just gonna warp it. Alright, so there's our five, and we'll head back to the base. Oh my gosh. Alright, and actually, now that I think about it, I did make up some Draconic Fusion crafting injectors. Because I was playing around with, automating them and stuff, so I went ahead and made some of those before. So we'll just use those to upgrade. Alright, and there's five Chaotic Cores. I'm making three more right now. Which, of course, will put us up at our eight that we need. And then we can upgrade our fusion crafting injectors. It's just gonna take four diamonds and a dragon egg for each one. So let's get our eight dragon eggs. These actually do take a little bit of power to create. And then let's see, we're also going to want those cores. We're gonna need brand new cores. So to do it, we're just gonna need eight of them. I'll tell you what, I can put those in there, and that is for the Chaotic Fusion crafting injectors. Which they're gonna be nice, but man, are they expensive. And I'm not gonna worry just yet about making, right now we have 10 injectors. I'm just gonna make 8. To start with, and then maybe down the road or something, if we need the 10, which I don't think we really will, but we might upgrade those or something. All right, so while we're waiting on that, let me show you how the rudimentary snares work in case you're not familiar with it or whatever. I'm gonna turn that down a bit. I'm not too worried about hostile creatures right now in Sky Factory. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna hit these blazes until we notice some potion effects around them. There we go. And then if we just kill that blaze, you'll notice we got some demonic wheel. This one has 2.95 wheel quality. And I've actually got to fix this wall here because I absolutely annihilated it. But anyways, that's pretty much how you go about getting that wheel if if you're just starting out. Now keep in mind that is just for starting out. There's a lot better ways to get wheel after you have a little bit of it to start with. I don't know, honestly, I still don't know where that wheel came from, but I'll take it. So I will happily take it. It's only a rank one though. That's what's strange, is it's all rank one. So I don't know. But anyways, we've got our demonic wheel. That's great. And so now let's go ahead and start with blood magic. And starting out, once you get the wheel that you need, it's fairly the same starting out with just a few minor changes. So the first thing that we're going to want is, of course, our sacrificial dagger. We're not going to do probably too much with blood magic today. Just kind of, basically just jumpstart it. Because realistically we just don't have the time left this episode to get too crazy with it, but we'll start it up. And I think what we'll do is we're actually going to bring this up just a little bit. Not quite sure what he did in this room. It's all lopsided. But we're going to say this is going to be the center, and we'll adjust the room size as we need moving forward. But we're going to put our blood altar right here, I think. And then, of course, we begin the fun process of stabbing ourselves. Which, if you notice, with environmental tech, it's not too bad because we have regen 2. So, it's not too bad. I just kind of want to get that, you know, basically the beginning parts of Blood Magic done today, at least. Then we can get a little bit farther with it, you know, as time goes on. I'm going to remove a few of these, I think. We can leave the draconic level ones. We can leave those. It's not going to hurt anything. It's just if we're doing any kind of chaotic level infusion, then we're going to need to make sure and use the chaotic ones. But we can still use the draconic ones for the draconic level crafting. That's not really an issue. So, okay. So there we go. We've got our chaotic level infusion injectors. So, good stuff. I'm going to go ahead and lay this stuff out. We're going to make some awakened cores. I don't believe that there is anything that requires 9 or 10 of the chaotic fusion. I don't believe that there is, but I could be mistaken. There we go. That'll start running. Okay, so now that that's going, we'll let that run for just a bit, and then we can get our solar panels crafted. And so while we're waiting on that, let's go ahead and get back into Blood Magic just a little bit. Of course, the next thing that we're going to need is a bit of stone. And I think we're going to move fairly briskly through Blood Magic. You know, basically cover all the new stuff and kind of get into it a little bit, but we are going to move at a decent pace through it. So what we can do is, of course, we can throw our stone in there. And I do apologize about the noise. It's so loud. And we're basically just going to make ourselves a bit of these blank slates. I mean, basically, this is the beginning of Blood Magic. If you guys aren't familiar with it, you know that this is how it goes. So, I mean, there's a couple other items. I've covered Blood Magic in detail in other series. And as you guys know, this isn't quite so tutorial-esque. But just keep in mind that you do have the Blood Letters Pack and the Coat of Arms. Blood Letters Pack, of course, being, I don't know, I don't personally like it because it basically, you're out in the world, it does get blood, which is nice, but it also keeps you damaged, you know, and so I'm just kind of like, eh, I don't know. But basically, I want to go for just 8 speed runes to get us started, which is going to be 16 blank slates that we're going to need for that. Oh yeah, we're going to need our weak blood orb too, aren't we? Almost forgot about that. let's get ourselves a diamond, and then there is a book in Blood Magic right here, the Inspectora Scandalum. I am going to want this. We're just going to need a book and throw it in our altar. These are the main two items that I want to go over with you guys. Because if you're not familiar with the Spectora Scandalum, it is a very, very handy item to have. So we're going to throw that in there. Get ourselves a bit of blood essence in the altar. And let's also go ahead and throw our diamond in here so we can get our blood orb. So the Inspectora Scandalum, you can right-click to set different tiers. And so we're going to go ahead and set our blood altar to a tier 6. Honestly, I don't think that the tier 6 is implemented yet within Blood Magic in 1.10. But we'll go ahead and plan for it just in case it's added at some point. Then what we can do is we can just right-click, or is it shift-right-click our altar. And you can see that it actually lays out your altar design for you. I may actually have to drop this. Well, no, we have room to expand this, so that's okay. Because I believe that the capstones are going to be right there, so that's not a problem. We'll just expand it. We'll bring the ceiling up by 1 or maybe even 2. Because I have an idea how I want to lay this room out, once we get to that. And the weak Blood Orb, we'll just go ahead and right-click to bind it to ourself. It says current owner to Asgard. Wonderful. And then back over here, we can go ahead and make ourselves our blank slates that we need. There's three of those. That's all we're going to be able to craft right this second. And then go ahead and... Oh, wait, I used up all of them. Never mind. We're going to need blank slates, and then we'll get our speed runes and start laying out our altar a little bit. But anyways, let's pop over here. Our awakened cores should be done, but they're not. Oh, I didn't plug the power back up. After I changed out the injectors, I didn't plug the power back up. So basically, it's very, very slowly getting any kind of power. That's not going to work. Okay, there we go. Now it's running. It's got power and everything. Wonderful. I totally forgot about that. It's one of my very, very... It's growingly more and more common, I think. The derps, I think. So, all right, so let me pop back over there while that's running, and I'm going to get a few more of these blank slates. And we got our first two speed runes. Now, we're basically just going to go for 8 of these. Like I said, this is something I'll keep working on off camera. A lot of the blood magic build-up kind of stuff is going to be a lot of off-camera because the beginning of blood magic is very, very grindy. And that, I mean, that's one thing that hasn't changed. If anything, in 1.10, that's actually gotten worse due to the fact that you need the souls. So, it'll mainly be an off-camera kind of progression at the beginning. But chances are, maybe next episode we might begin doing a little bit of, you know, automation with it, like essence collection and stuff like that. Just using spawners, we're not going to be stabbing ourselves much longer at all. So, and it really, realistically, it wouldn't be hard for us to kind of get some automated essence. Tell you what, this regen too makes starting blood magic so easy. It really, really does. All right, there's our last three speed runes. Very, very nice, and we can get this altar upgraded. That will definitely make our lives a whole lot easier. And then let's pop over here. These awaken cores are done. And so to actually get our solar panels, it's 4 cores, 4 solar panels, and then a chaos shard. And that's going to make 3 of them. So, I mean, this is going to go a decent ways because these things do generate a massive amount of power. So, we'll just go ahead and lay these out and go. Yeah. Why is my timer not starting it? That's bizarre. I mean, it does say, like, the energy cost is really strange. So there's negative 589,934,000. Whereas normally they just say energy cost is this. Okay, give me just a second here. Let me see if I can figure this out. I actually have no clue. I was looking online about it, and apparently some other people have reported the same issue. I have no clue. I actually have no absolute clue as to why that's not working. I even tried putting these in one at a time like that. I have no clue. Redstone doesn't start it. I can't start it. And it just doesn't seem craftable at all. So, I have no clue. I'm going to do a bit of looking and see. I mean, I believe our Sky Factory version is up to date. But I'm going to see if I'm going to keep digging around and see if I can find any more information on it. But right now, it's uncraftable. So, next episode, we'll probably continue with blood magic a little bit, I think. I do believe so. So, and I apologize, we weren't able to craft those. Like, that was actually a big undertaking that I was working on. And then it's just not even usable. So right now, is there actually any use at all for the Chaos Shards? I mean, I know, well, I guess we could do the upgrades for gear. But I mean, see, it's weird because this says 800,000 energy cost. This says negative 589 million, or 800 million and negative 580. I don't know. It's really bizarre. So, I mean, we can look in here and see that these, I mean, these actually generate a decent amount. It's 131,000 RF per tick. I guess it's a little bit more reasonable, but the cost really isn't that high for us at this point. I don't know if maybe these need to charge up and then we can put them in. And I'll let these charge for a bit and see if maybe that fixes it. Maybe if these are all fully charged, then suddenly it'll work. I don't know. By the way, I'm recording an outro right now just in case this does not work. So if you're seeing this outro, that means that charging up the solar panels did not work because I feel like it's a long shot. But I'm going to let these charge for a little while and then try them at full charge. So, but if you're seeing this outro, just know that it did not work at all. So just a heads up on that. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. I know we didn't get as much done as I was really hoping to, because I was planning on getting the solar panels done and then messing with blood magic a little bit. We did get a little bit of blood magic started. That was my main goal, was to get the grindy part started and underway. And then next episode, hopefully we'll come back. Hopefully we'll have a tier 2 altar or something by then, so we can start moving forward with, getting a little bit of automation with it, because I hate the beginning of blood magic. Absolutely hate it. But I want to work towards those item conduits so that we can automate Draconic Evolution. Realistically, there's not a whole lot of point to automate Draconic Evolution, but we're going to do it just for fun. Because at this point, I mean, we have tons of resources. We're just kind of doing things for fun at this point. So, I do need to get this moved. I'll probably try to move this by next episode as well. And I'll continue working on the ship. I'm kind of approaching getting the actual hull done, and then I'll start the accents and the decorating and stuff on the sides. I gotta add windows on this side, and then I'll start doing some of the accents and the golden gears and things like that on the side of it. But yeah, so anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, as always, be sure and hit that like button and go ahead and subscribe if you're not already for more daily videos. And until next time, as always, do take care and stay safe. And I will see you guys next time.